Hi, I'm Lana Condor, and I play Lara Jean.
I'm Noah Centineo, and I play Peter Kavinsky.
We are so excited for To All the Boys, Always and Forever that we wanted to read a bit from the book. When I come down the stairs, Peter is sitting on the couch with his mom.
He's shaking his knee up and down, which is how I know he's nervous, too.
As soon as he sees me, he stands up. He raises his eyebrows.
You look... wow. For the past week, he's been asking for details on what my dress looks like, and I held him at bay for the surprise, which I'm glad I did, because it was worth it to see the look on his face.
You look wow, too. His tux fits him so nicely. You'd think it was custom, but it's not. It's a rental from After Hours Formal Wear. I wonder if Mrs. Kavinsky made a few sly adjustments.
I wish guys could wear tuxedos more often, though I suppose that would take some of the thrill away.
Peter slides my corsage onto my wrist.
It is white, ranunculus, and baby's breath, and it's the exact corsage I would have picked for myself.
I'm already thinking of how I'll hang it over my bed so it dries just so.
Kitty is dressed up too. She has on her favorite dress so she can be seen in the pictures. When Peter pins a daisy corsage on her, her face goes pink with pleasure and he winks at me.
We take a picture of me and her, one of me, Peter, and her, and then she says in her bossy way, "Now, just one of me and Peter."
And I'm pushed off to the side with Trina, who laughs. And why am I not in any of these pictures? Daddy wonders. So of course we do a round with him too, and a few with Trina and Mrs. Kavinsky.
Then we take pictures outside, by the dogwood tree, by Peter's car, on the front steps.
Until Peter says, "All right, enough pictures. We're gonna miss the whole thing."
When we go to his car, he opens the door for me gallantly. On the way over, he keeps looking at me.
I keep my eyes trained straight ahead, but I can see him in my periphery. I've never felt so admired. As soon as we get to prom, I tell Peter we have to get in line to take our official prom picture with the professional photographer.
He says we should just wait till the line dies down, but I insist. I want a good one for my scrapbook before my hair goes flat.
We do the requisite prom pose, with Peter standing behind me, his hands on my hips.
The photographer lets us look at our picture, and Peter insists on taking another one because he doesn't like the way his hair looks.
After we take our picture, we find all of our friends on the dance floor. Daryl has matched his tie to Pammy's dress, lavender.
Chris is wearing a tight black bandage dress, not unlike the one Kitty picked out for me to wear when she and Margot and I went shopping.
Lucas looks like an English dandy in his suit,
which is tailored to his body just beautifully. I finally convinced the two of them to come by suggesting they just stop by. Chris said she was still going clubbing with her work friends, but from the looks of it, she isn't going anywhere anytime soon.
Style comes on and we all go crazy, screaming in each other's faces and jumping up and down. Peter goes craziest of all. He keeps asking me if I'm having fun.
He only asks out loud once, but with his eyes he asks me again and again. They are bright and hopeful, alight with expectation.
With my eyes I tell him, yes, 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 I am having fun.
We're starting to get the hang of slow dancing too.
Maybe we should take a ballroom dancing class when I go to UVA so we can actually get good at it.
I tell him this and fondly he says, "You always want to take things to the next level."
Next level chocolate chip cookies.
I gave up on those.
Next level Halloween costumes.
I like for things to feel special.
At this, Peter smiles down at me and I say,
"It's just too bad we'll never dance cheek to cheek."
"Well, maybe we can order you some dancing stilts."
"Oh, you mean high heels?"
He snickers. "I don't think there's such a thing as 10-inch heels."
I ignore him. "And it's too bad your noodle arms aren't strong enough to pick me up."
Peter lets out a roar like an injured lion, "Ah!" and swoops me up and swings me around, just like I knew he would.
It's a rare thing to know someone so well, whether they'll pivot left or right.
Outside of my family, I think he might be the person I know best of all.
Of course, Peter wins prom king.
Prom queen is Ashanti Dixon. I'm just relieved it isn't Genevieve up there, slow dancing with him with a tiara on her head.
Ashanti is nearly Peter's height, so the two of them actually can dance cheek to cheek, but they don't.
Peter looks out at me and winks. I'm standing off to the side with Marshawn Hopkins, Ashanti's date.
He leans over to me and says, "When they come back, we should ignore them and just dance away," which makes me laugh.
I'm proud of Peter out there and how he dances so tall with his back so straight. At a pivotal moment in the song, Peter dips Ashanti and everyone hoots and hollers and stomps their feet, and I'm proud of that too.
People are so sincere in their affection for him.
He just gives the night a little extra shine, and they are glad for it. And so am I. I'm happy he gets his send-off.
One last dance. We're both quiet. It's not over yet.
We still have the whole summer ahead, but high school, the two of us here together, Lara Jean and Peter, as we are today, that part is done. we'll never be here exactly like this again.
I'm wondering if he's feeling sad too, and then he whispers.
Check out Gabe over there, trying to casually rest his hand on Keisha's butt.
He turns me slightly so I can see.
I giggle. This is why I like Peter so much. He sees things I don't see.
I know what our song should be, he says. What?
And then, like magic, Al Green's voice fills the hotel ballroom. Let's stay together.
You made them play this, I accuse. I'm tearing up a little bit.
He grins. It's fate.
Whatever you want to do is all right with me. Peter takes my hand and puts it on his heart.
Let's stay together, he sings.
His voice is clear and true, and everything I love about him.
Aww.
That passage just hit me. Beautiful.
That was just a little sneak peek of the book. And you can watch To All the Boys, Always and Forever on Netflix.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.